Muhammad Umar Farooq biological video, please make sure to subscribe, like and share. Ask the question for answer and comment about the artwork. You can also answer question to either for solving the problem. So here we will discuss about today's circulatory system in human. So the human circulatory system is the double circuit circulatory system as well as closed circulatory system. So the four chamber heart are present in human being, or we can say that the mammal. So four chamber heart mean the two atrium and two ventricle, which that is septum is present, ventricular septum is present. So here is the person. Let's we will discuss about the whole detail about the circulatory system and pulmonary circulatory system and systemic circulatory system, and we will also understand about the anatomical aspect of the heart. So here is the heart. This heart is basically contain a inferior and superior vena cava, while the aorta are present, which that is contain a oxygenated blood move toward the body, while the superior and inferior vena cava which collect the deoxygenated blood into the heart, which that is the right atrium to right ventricle, and go into the pulmonary artery toward the lungs for bathing the oxygen and release the carbon dioxide during the breathing. So here is the carotid artery, which also required for the head region to supply the oxygenated blood, while that carotid vein is used for the move into the inferior vena cava. So here is the descending aorta, apex of heart, which that is left and right atrium and right left and right ventricle. So let's begin to understand the whole mechanism of the circulation of the blood in our body via pulmonary circulation and systemic circulation. So let's begin to understand. Here is a superior vena cava, which does collect the deoxygenated blood through the body, upper body, while here the inferior vena cava, which that is collect the deoxygenated blood from the capillary to move into the venule to vein and go into the inferior vena cava. So that means here is the inferior and superior vena cava, which that is drain the blood into the left atrium. So the left atrium to left ventricle. So when move into the left atrium to left ventricle, that is cycle complete. That is the relaxation phase. It is known as the diastole phase. So let's begin to hear. We can say that here is the aorta and aortic wall is present, while here when move the blood into the right atrium, so it means also fill the left atrium with the oxygenated blood. So the completely contraction of the atrial contraction, both atrium will be contract due to the sinoatrial node depolarization. So this depolarization is the pacemaker are present, which that is lead to depolarization to contract the muscle of the myocardium of the heart muscle. So here is the pulmonary artery left and right, which that is give the after the contraction of the atrium, the pulmonary artery will lead to move into the lungs. And after the bathing of the blood, move back due to the left pulmonary vein. So remember, the pulmonary vein is due to the oxygenated blood is move into the heart. So that is why we are saying that it is artery, because because it is containing oxygenated blood, but it is moved toward the heart. So that is why it is known as the vein, while the deoxygenated blood is through the artery. So when move into the blood into the lungs and back into the left pulmonary artery vein and right pulmonary vein to move into the left atrium, and after the move into the left atrium, that mean both atrium contain one is contain deoxygenated blood and one contain oxygenated blood contract together during the sinoatrial node depolarization of the nerves. So the nervous system is important for it. So here is a filling of the right ventricle. Before the contraction of atrium, the ventricle is filled 90% already, or 80%. But when contraction completely of the atrium, then ventricle will be contract, that is known as the systolic pressure. So this diastole during the filling of the heart and systolic pressure during the contraction of the heart to eject the blood into the aorta as well as the pulmonary artery. So here is the descending aorta and aortic arch, which that is supply the blood throughout the body. So here is the sinoatrial node, which that depolarization to contract the atrium, while here is the atrioventricular node, which that give the signal to depolarization throughout the heart apex movement from the heart apex to ventricle contraction. After this contraction, that is the systolic pressure. So the systolic pressure and diastolic pressure is the basically 120 over 80 millimeter of mercury. So here is the sympathetic nervous system, which that is increase the heart rate during the walking or running or exercise. But during the rest, the parasympathetic nervous system activate to decrease heartbeat 72 beat per minute, while the increased heart rate can be as a normal person 80 beats per minute. So that is the sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system antagonistically work and keep the homeostasis stage. So let's begin to understand the major aspect of anatomical structure. So I am drawing the again heart diagram to understand the anatomy of the heart. So the heart is contain a different type of tissue. So these different type of tissue we will discuss in this diagram. So here is the heart. This heart is contain a pulmonary vein and pulmonary artery, which that and pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein is here. And this pulmonary artery which give the blood deoxygenated blood toward the lungs, while the pulmonary vein is give the oxygenated blood toward the heart. So that is the basic concept about that. So here is the blue color shows that the deoxygenated blood. So here is the papillary muscle, which that is papillary muscle is attached with the cordy tendon, or you can say that the cusp of right atrioventricular tricuspid valve, and that is papillary muscle is contain attached with the cordy tendon, and that is used for the movement of the heart upward and shorten the apex range. So that is why eject the blood more tightly. While more important thing is that the basically left ventricle is rigid and high and contain a more muscular, because it required the supply of the blood throughout the body. So that's more pressure. So here is the also left ventricle and right ventricle, while the left atrium and left ventricle right atrium. And here is important thing is that sinoatrial node are present, we will discuss later, but first of all we will discuss about the right ventricle here, which that contain a deoxygenated blood, while the left ventricle contain a oxygenated blood during the heartbeat. So here is important cusp of left atrioventricular wall or mitral wall. So atrioventricular wall or mitral wall, which that is allow the oxygenated blood move into the ventricle, and that's ultimately during the systolic pressure the heart will pump the blood into the aortic valve and open the aortic valve to move the blood out into the body. So here important thing here is the heart apex. So the heart apex is the basically dome like structure downward, you can see. So on the other hand, the three layer of the heart is known as the epicardium and pericardium or myocardium and endocardium. Epicardium contain a basically envelope, While the myocardial envelope is basically contain a tissue, while the endocardium is the inside, which that is inside epithelial cell are present, and that is the rigid also. So on the other hand, that is the layer of heart, and inferior vena cava is looking like this, which that is the inferior and superior vena cava used for the blood supply into the blood, deoxygenated blood, while the aorta contain oxygenated blood, which that move outward. So important thing is that aorta contain a higher pressure, while the artery contain a less and less, and capillary too much less. So that is why the blood pressure is not effect to the endothelial cell of the artery. So the artery is more rigid as compared to the more elastic and decrease the blood pressure. So that is why during the older age that will be rigid and increase the blood pressure. So important thing that the vein is contain a low blood pressure, so that is why it is thin as compared to the artery. So here I am drawing the heart again to understand the valve of the heart, which that is also anatomical aspect. So here is the heart, which contain a right atrioventricular valve or tricuspid valve, and left atrioventricular valve or bicuspid valve, while the pulmonary valve is the basically used for the pulmonary circulation, and atrioventricular valve or right aortic valve, which that is rigid and hard, which that is when closed, it means the backward movement of the blood is impossible. So that means when the aortic valve will be damaged, so it means the heart will not completely eject the blood. So here is the three leaflets are present in right tricuspid valve. So that is known as the tricuspid valve. That is why. On the other hand, here is the aortic valve, which that is the right aortic valve is the three leaflets contain, and here is the open. And aortic valve is rigid and hard. So that means it is require the more blood pressure. So that means when it's closed, the backward movement of the blood is impossible. While on the other hand, one more thing is important, the vein is also contain a valve. Why? Because vein is inhibit the backward movement of the blood. So here is the left bicuspid valve, which that is also known as the atrioventricular valve, which contain our two cusp or two leaflets. So let's begin to understand of the systemic circulation and pulmonary circulation. So the pulmonary circulation means the heart pump the blood into the lungs, while the systemic circulation means the heart pump the blood into the tissue or into the body. So here is the pulmonary valve. We will understand that is the pulmonary valve contain also three leaflets. So the three leaflets, it's the pulmonary valve, which that is allow the movement of the blood into the lungs. So that means when it's closed, so the backward movement of the blood is impossible. So let's begin to understand the systemic circulation and pulmonary circulation right way. So here is during when we will breathe in, so it means the oxygen will move inside due to the lower pressure of the partial pressure of the oxygen in low in the lungs, while move the carbon dioxide outside due to the inside the more partial pressure of the carbon dioxide, so it means the movement of the carbon dioxide is outside more. So that means it is breathing mechanism is antagonistically work due to the changes of the partial pressure in the environment as compared to the human body into the lungs. So here is the heart I am drawing, which contain a systemic circulation and pulmonary circulation. So the systemic circulation contain a tissue, which that is bathed by the capillaries. So the oxygenated blood will give the oxygen to the tissue for the aerobic respiration and during the Krebs cycle, and absorb the carbon dioxide to convert the carbaminohemoglobin, while the oxyhemoglobin on the other hand. So the deoxygenated blood backward into the superior and inferior vena cava to move into the right atrium, and right atrium to move the right ventricle, and move ultimately into the pulmonary circulation via a pulmonary artery. So that's pulmonary artery when go into the alveoli surrounded by the air sac of the alveoli, and alveolus contain a air sac which they are surrounded and contain a air. Air contain a carbon dioxide and oxygen. So the when amount of the during the breathe in, the amount of the oxygen is more. So that is why the oxygen absorbed into the blood via a iron containing a hemoglobin molecule of the red blood cell which attach the oxygen. So that means oxygen will be attached with the blood to become a oxyhemoglobin. So while on the other hand, important thing is that when the carbon dioxide will be released into the lungs, so that's move into the air sac. And when move into the air sac, that will be breathed out due to the partial pressure increase inside as compared to the environment. So that means it is the involuntary control of the breathing. While we can stop our breathing a short time, but it's unable to stop the breathing because it is involuntary response by the nervous system. So here you can see that here the oxygenated blood will move inside, oxygenated blood moves outside of the heart and basically give the oxygen toward the tissue, and that means through a capillary, which that's capillary surrounded by the tissue throughout the body. And after this capillary, the deoxygenated blood move into the backward into the right atrium to right ventricle, and move into the pulmonary artery to pulmonary vein to move back into the left atrium to left ventricle. So that is important thing. So thanks for watching. Bye. Give the suggestion and